Hello, and welcome back to PolyToots. In today's video, we're going to be looking at a particle-based slash effect. And I say particle-based because there are a few ways to do slashes and swipes, strikes, swings, swooshes, slices, and other similar meaning words that all strangely start with an S. But the method in this video will use the default particle system. We're also going to make a simple shader with Shader Graph to help out with this. There is also an Amplify version, along with all source files available for freebies over on my Patreon if that's what you're into. And of course, a big, big thank you to all my current supporters. It really means a lot. So let's talk about our particle mesh first. I've made a simple one in Blender for this, and I've also used Blender to paint in a basic texture, because if you see what it looks like on the right and compare it to the actual texture we get on the left, you'll notice that it's not the same. And that's because we're painting on a curved mesh that has straight UVs, which is important for the shader part of this tutorial. The easiest way to get straight UVs on a curved mesh is to just start with a straight mesh, like a plane, so your UVs will already be straight, and then just add in some loops and bend the mesh afterwards. Alright, so let's get started in Unity here, and we'll start by adding a particle system into the scene, and we only need to spawn one particle, so I'm going to change the emission so that the rate over time is zero, and instead we'll add a burst and make sure we're spawning just one. Now this needs to stay in place and obviously spawn a lot quicker, so we'll change the duration to 1 and the lifetime to something small like 0.2 for now. What this means is the particle will respawn every second, but it will only exist for 0.2 seconds. Next, we need to get rid of the start speed so it stops moving, and also disable the shape to make sure it respawns in the same location. What we're left with here is a blip, basically, and right now it's just spawning a default particle, which is a quad that's always facing the camera, whereas we want our own mesh, and we want to orbit around it like a regular 3D object. So down in the renderer tab, we can change the render mode to mesh, and then assign our slash mesh. It still looks a little weird because it's billboarded, so make sure to change the render alignment to local. You'll probably want to reset the rotations of the particle system as well, because for some reason they always come in with a minus 90 on the X. If we check the wireframe of this, you can see it is using our mesh, and it's still using the default particle material. So we'll leave the particle system side alone for now, and we'll get busy with the shader. We'll be using an unlit shader for this, and since we're using the Universal Render Pipeline, we can get what we want in the Create menu, go to Shader, Universal Render Pipeline, and choose Unlit Shader Graph. Give it a name, and then just open it up. I'm going to change the directory of the shader here to something more personal, and we also need to set some stuff up before we start plunking down the nodes. In the graph settings, which if it isn't there for you, then just click the Graph Inspector button over here. We're actually going to leave the surface as opaque, which might sound like crazy town, but we're going to go with a cutout alpha for this, so all we need to do is check the alpha clip and we'll be fine. If you want soft alpha on your slashes, then you should switch the surface type to transparent, and then pick a blending mode. Anything except pre-multiplied is fine, because for some reason that still doesn't work in Shader Graph. The Amplify version over on my Patreon has pre-multiply blending if you wanted to check it out. It's just something that allows us to switch between additive and alpha blending modes with the opacity value. It's not essential, but definitely my preferred method for VFX. I talk a little bit more about this in my Diablo 3 tutorial, if you're feeling in the mood for a little more learning. I'll also tick the two-sided box, since our custom mesh has no back faces. And I'll save this now, and then create a material that uses this shader, and drag that material onto our mesh. Now any changes we make in the shader will update on our mesh. Neat! The nodes for this are going to be fairly simple, so let's start with a texture 2D property. Give it a name, and we'll plug this into a sample texture 2D. Since this is basically a particle shader, it makes sense to let the particle system itself have control over the color and alpha. So I'm going to grab a vertex color node and multiply that with the RGB of our texture before plugging it into the base color slot. I'll also split this vertex color node and multiply its alpha slot with the alpha of our texture and plug that into the alpha slot. This gives us that separate control on the particle system, one for the color and one for the alpha. And since we're using cutout alpha for this, it also makes sense to make a float and plug that into the alpha clip threshold. Make sure this is set to a slider and change the default to 0.5. If you leave this at 0, then you're not going to see anything when you make a new material with this shader. Let's save this out now and get our texture in here. If you're making your own textures, make sure the wrap mode is set to clamp, because later on we're going to mess with the tiling and we don't want it to keep repeating. Okay, so pretty basic stuff. We have a particle slash that is now just blipping in and out of existence. If I pause the simulation and adjust the alpha clip threshold, you will see the texture dissolve away. This is because it's basically clipping out certain grayscale ranges when you increase this value. So leave this at what you think looks like a good default state, and then we can tinker with the particle system a bit more. Obviously, the first thing you might think to change is the rotation of a lifetime, and you wouldn't be wrong. We will need to use separate axes for this, as we only need it to rotate along its local Y. It's still appearing and disappearing pretty strangely though, so we'll need to play with the alpha over lifetime as well. We'll start it as beginning invisible and ending invisible, and then be visible somewhere in between. If you start messing around with the colors here as well, and also adjusting the lifetime, you might be satisfied enough to call it a day, and I would completely understand. At the moment, this is for sure a passable slash. But we can make it better, and the first thing I want to introduce is some HDR values so we can get that bloom popping. You will also need some sort of post-processing to get bloom working, of course, but I'm just using the Unity default stuff here. So back to the shader then, we'll make a float and call this one HDR range, which I know is high dynamic range, but that's just life. This will also be a slider, and I'll set the default at 1, and the minimum should also be 1 because you'll never want to go below 1, and I'll set the max to 4. Now just multiply this into the texture setup here before the vertex color stuff. Quick little save to preview that. And yeah, that's doing what it's supposed to. So let's do the last thing, which is get some custom vertex streams involved so the slash starts off small and grows longer over time, instead of now where the whole texture appears but we're just dissolving it in and out. So to give a quick example of what I mean, I'm going to chuck down a tiling and offset node and stick in a vector 2 property. You can see on the material that if I adjust the X value, we are affecting the tiling, and we can take a look at this in wireframe for a clearer view. So we're able to squash and stretch the texture in this manner, but ideally we want this to be animated on the particle itself and not the material, so let's set that up. I'll remove the vector 2 property, but I'll keep the tiling and offset node. Then I'll get a UV coordinate node and split this into RGBA. The thing to keep in mind here is that the RNG slots are your U and V data, which are already in use by default, so we're going to have to use B and A, and we'll want to plug those into the tiling property. But remember that we only want to adjust the X tiling of our texture and not both X and Y. So we need to get a combined node, and we'll use the B and A slots of the split and put them into the R and G of the combine, and then output that to a vector 2 option in the tiling and offset node. Now we can go see what's what. At first it will look like something bad has happened, but don't worry too much because all that's happened is the tiling has basically defaulted to 0, and we'll get that back with CVS. So down in the renderer tab, let's enable custom vertex streams, and we're going to add one of our own via this little plus icon. We're only interested in one value here, since we just want to tweak the tiling on the X, so go to custom, custom1.x. Now just scroll up a bit and enable custom data, make custom1 a vector, and again, we only need a vector 1. So now it's doing the same thing we were able to do on the material, which you might think is pointless, but now we can turn this into a curve and mess about with the timings and values and play with the particle's properties until we're happy. So we can change things like the starting alpha, since now it starts small, so we don't need to have it be invisible. Maybe also rotate it a little less, change the lifetime, do whatever you want basically. The end result is much nicer than not adding in the custom vertex stream in my opinion, as even though this effect only lasts a mere moment, you can tell that there was some proper swing behind this attack. But of course if all you're after is a split second slash, then you could have stopped watching ages ago, but I appreciate you being here all the same. So that wraps it up for this one. Again, just to remind you that both the Shader Graph and Amplify additive versions of this scene are freely available over on my Patreon. Check it out, give it a like or a comment or whatever it is people do these days, I don't know. Thank you to all of my current patrons, you are a blessing. I will see you and hopefully everyone else in the next video. Peace out.